A letter is used when we want to send a communication to someone, and that communication is not within the home or office, it is an external communication. So when we are talking to people who are not in our organization, who are not in our family, we are writing a letter. We don't write a circular, we don't write a notice to them. You know what is a notice and a circular, we have been using them in the schools. Now, when I'm writing a letter, I need to convince you. How can I convince you? You know, when guests come to your home, you don't convince them right away by your words and your discussions. First, you convince them by the formalities that you do. What are the formalities? You take a glass of water and then you put it in a tray and then you serve it very well. In a very decent way, you do it. What is that? That is formality. Because we believe that formality, a structure, a pattern, a format, some rule book is there, the protocol is there that we should follow initially. After that, when we know each other, then we can write notices and circulars. That's what we do. So, but when I am there to impress you, you know, I have to convince you, I have to make you accept my proposal that I'm coming in a tray and then I'm bringing this water for you and then I'm just going to have it. When in your family, in my family, if somebody is just going to give me a glass of water, it might come in hands also and might say no also, that no, I don't want it now, I'll have it later. But when it is being served well, we have got a courtesy to even take a sip and then we return it probably. But there's a courtesy to accept things when they come with formality. So letter is a formal communication tool, dear children. We use it to communicate with external organizations and offices. The letter starts with the letterhead of the organization which is writing it. You can see there's a red line on the top. This red line means that we generally have a letterhead. Like if you are going to get a letter from the school, it on the top the name of the school will be written. And in school there are many offices. We have got the principal's office, we have got another office which is the examination office, we have got an accounts office, administration office, we have got a sports department, we have got cultural department, and then we have got various departments. And suppose the letter is coming from a department of the school, it is not coming from the principal's office, then that person will be writing the address, means it will be sports department, block this, room number this, and then they will start the letter. I guess that is a simple explanation of it, that the sender to whom the reply will be going. Why return address is written? Because the reply from the person who is receiving this letter will be coming up to this person or this address particularly. Address will remain the same. People can change. One day I might be writing for the sports department, next day you might be writing for the cultural department. So that is what happens. But address remains the same. So on the top, on the left hand side, everything on the left, we write the address on the left hand side. Don't forget, on the left. So three lines, I guess, this and this number, house number maybe, then maybe some sector or some other colony or something, and then you write the city. You don't write the name of the sender here. Then you write the date. There are three ways: recommended, suggested, maybe shared is also a word. I wish that you don't use this one, a hyphen one. We use this one and we put a comma here. In this one we don't put a comma, in this one we put a dot, 10.04. This, prefer the first two, means one of the two. So we write the date and then we leave some space, you know, we are putting brick over brick, we are putting block over block. So between the blocks we are putting some gaps so that these are these can be seen separately. Inside address is the address of the receiver, how the person is addressed in the organization. We don't write Parveen Kumar. We'll be writing the educator, Wisdom World School, Kurukshetra, or the principal, Wisdom World School, Kurukshetra. Dear children, now we don't write the word two. We simply write those three lines, 1, 2, 3, designation, organization, and city. Then we write the subject. Subject should be written not as sub, it has to be SUBJECT. If you are using a bold pen, then it can be provided boldness. Otherwise, underlining is required. The subject sentence or the line is never a sentence generally. It is something which is incomplete. It is a description of something. It is descriptive, but it is not considered a sentence. So you do not mark a full stop at the end of it. Do remember, I shall be the first one to deduct your marks because of it. So this is what we will be doing. The second thing is salutation after subject. We write dear sir, dear ma'am, and all these things are being written by us. We do not write MAM. Avoid writing it. The safest thing will be dear sir, dear ma'am, respected sir, respected madam. Madam is fine. And dear Mr. Singh, or all these things we know. We have been using them. The body of the letter will have three components of communication. I'm not saying three paragraphs. No, I'm not saying that you are required to make it only three. It can be 7 paragraphs, it can be 10 paragraphs, it can be three. But it must have three segments of communication. First one, you need to tell the reason of writing the problem, reason of writing the letter, and the problem statement should be given. You should tell why the letter has been written. Then you say that I wish to state that I'm suffering from high fever and today I cannot come to the school. Oh, that is why the letter is written. And then you explain, I got my test yesterday. This is seasonal viral. This is what I wish that we can afford to have that one, probably, just to get safe from the other thing, the other dangerous thing. So I would explain it. The doctor has advised, my report is saying this. Doctor says that for 3 days I should be on bed and I should not be maybe working hard. That way, physical strain is not suggested. So we give the explanation. This is the time when you become an advocate or a counsel or a wakil or a lawyer. You give explanation to justify your problem, that yes, this is a valid problem, I should be awarded something. But what is that? When you believe that you have given enough explanation that is sufficient actually, and the other person who's receiving it, the one to whom you have written this letter, is convinced now, then you tell them what they should be doing. You know, don't make it that thing that in which you are doing tapasya and God comes and say, mango vat kya mangte ho, and then you say, just give me 5 minutes, I'll just ask Praveen sir through MS Teams chat, and then you are waiting for it. No, action request should be known to you. You should tell the person exactly what you need. चाहिए क्या आपको? You are asking for leave, you are asking for permission, you are asking for blessings, you are asking for nothing. So put it in clear language, what is the reason or the problem which is making you write the letter, otherwise you would have met the person personally, face to face. Details and explanation of the problem or the reason to support it. The third one, action required from the receiver. After writing this, our segment completes. This, all these things are required to be very much accurate in grammar, spellings and everything. We don't leave any space. We start everything from the left. All the three paragraphs will start from the left. We don't leave that 0.5 space now. Expression of goodwill, we call it. We write it the way it is written. Thanking you in anticipation. Hoping for a favorable response is sometimes written. Thank you, thanking you. But a full stop is compulsory here. This is called complimentary clause. Yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours obediently is something which is being kept only as the third option, not as the first one. Yours doesn't have an apostrophe. We don't have S capital here, and there is no comma here. Remember, there is no comma with dear sir, madam, and there is no comma here as well. Here. So then you put the signatures if you're writing a printed one. Otherwise, you write your name and then you can write your designation also. And here the letter ends. Now, just to rewind the tape and talk about what are letters. They are used for external communication. The format that you have just seen is called block format. Every part is indented to the left. Everything is on the left. We are not pressing the tab or leaving some space in front of some lines. We are not justifying the text. You know what does it do? If we are going to justify it, everything will become equal on left and right. In the body of the letter, the paragraphs should not be indented. They should be kept on the left. Each paragraph will begin from the extreme left. No punctuation mark is used after subject statement, salutation and complimentary clause. If you use a punctuation mark after dear sir, then you have to use a punctuation mark after yours sincerely also. So it is better to avoid the confusion and keep a no punctuation mark rule here. So this is letter writing that we have just discussed in the format.